Hello friends, welcome to another session on the greedy approach. Today we'll look at an interesting problem, that is job scheduling problem, and we'll be using a greedy approach here to get the optimum solution. Before we actually start with what it is, let me take a simple example to make the concept a little bit simple. Suppose there is a mechanic who opens his shop in the morning and he's got some schedule, fixed schedule, right? As soon as he opens the shop, there are 5 customers waiting for him outside to get the job done. Maybe the repair job or something, right? And each customer has some schedule or some deadline. Like customer one wants his job to be done only within 1 hour. Customer second also wants his job to be done within 2 hours. Customer third wants the job to be done within 1 hour, right? Each person has a deadline, and within that specific deadline, the mechanic has to complete their job. Now the problem is what? There are overlapping jobs and there's a constraint of the deadline. And if for each job, if he completes, he gets some profit. So each job has some profit associated with it. Now what mechanic has to do? He has to select the jobs in such a way that he can schedule the jobs, like he's the only person who is working on it, and he should get the maximum profit. And when he's selecting the jobs, he has to take care of the deadline also, how fast the customer wants the job to be done. So this is a simple concept, what we'll be looking at in a greedy approach. So let us look at it. Now the sequencing of jobs on a single processor with deadline constraints is called a job sequencing with deadlines. So here, instead of single processor, you can call it as a single machine or a single person who was a mechanic, what I told you before, right? With the deadline constraint, like each job has a deadline. Within that deadline, the job should be completed. Now here, what you have, your set of jobs are given, right? Each job has a defined deadline and some profit associated with it, right? If he completes a job, what will be his profit? The profit of a job is given only when the job is completed within its deadline, right? If the job has deadline of one, let's say 1 hour, then the job should be completed within 1 hour, otherwise he'll not get the profit. Only one processor is available for processing all the jobs, so he cannot have parallel jobs at the same time. Simultaneously, you cannot do multiple jobs. Only one job can be carried out at a single time. Now, processor takes 1 unit of time to complete a job. This is what we assume. We assume the processor takes 1 unit of time to complete a job. Now, here we are applying greedy algorithm to determine how the next job is selected for an optimal solution. See, we use greedy algorithm whenever there's optimal solution problem. And here you have to select the maximum profit. So again, it's a maximization problem. So let us start. Let us look at the algorithm of job scheduling. So what you do in the step one, sort all the given jobs in decreasing order of their profit. Each job has a profit associated with it. So we sort them in descending order. Step two, check the value of maximum deadline. This is very important, right? Because then it decides like how many hours are there for a mechanic to work. Now, draw a net chart where maximum time of net chart is the value of the maximum deadline, right? So we'll be putting a net chart and we'll be putting the entries there. Pick up the jobs one by one, fine, from the job schedule. Put the job on net chart as far as possible from zero, ensuring that the job gets completed before its deadline, fine? Now we'll see all these steps with a good example, so the concept will be more clear. Okay, now given the jobs and deadlines and associated profit, right? This is an example what we're going to solve. So here you have jobs J1 to J5. There are 5 jobs, and J1 should be completed within 2 units of time, or you can say within 2 hours. J2 needs to be completed within 1 hour. J3 needs to be completed within 3 hours. J4 within 2 hours, and J5 within 1 hour, right? And if you complete J1 within 2 hours, the profit is 60. If J2 gets completed within 1 hour, then the profit is 100, right? Similarly, for J3, profit is 20, J4, profit is 40. And for J5, again, the profit is 20, right? And we need to schedule these jobs so that you get maximum profit. Now, what is the step one? Sort all the given jobs in decreasing order of their profit. So you sort this table again. So this is what you get. The profit of job J2 is 100, that is maximum. So it is first, then 60, then 40, then 20 and 20, fine. So the first job is J2, J1, J4, J5, and J3. Is it fine? Now, the step two is what? You need to find out the value of maximum deadline. Now, what is the value of maximum deadline? You can see deadline is 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. So maximum deadline is 3, right? So maximum deadline is 3. So what we do? We draw a net chart. Now, this is a net chart, right? It gives a time slot from 0 time to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, right? So the job which needs to be completed within 1 hour should be placed here. Job which needs to be completed within 2 hours can be placed here. Job which needs to be completed within 3 hours can be placed here. Fine. Now, what we do is we take each job one by one in order they appear in step one. So this is a sorted. So we take one by one. Now place the job on net chart as far as possible from 0. Now the very first job which is giving you maximum profit is J2 and its deadline is 1, right? So you need to schedule it between this time slot of 0 to 1. So J2 is scheduled here. So we just put it in the net chart. Now, this is step 3. Take job J2. Since its deadline is 1, so we place it in the first empty cell before the deadline 1, right? Is this clear? The other set of jobs, they are sorted in descending order based on the profit. You have a net chart which is designed using the maximum time slot, that is 3 of the deadline, right? And you select the first job, check its deadline and accordingly place it in the net chart. Now the deadline is 1, so please place it here. If J2's deadline is 3, then you would have placed it here. If it is 2, you would have placed it here, fine? Now, next, take the job J1 with the next maximum profit, right? Now, what is its deadline? Deadline is 2. So you need to place it in the second slot of the net chart before the deadline 2, fine? Next. Now, next, what you select is J3, right? The job J3 with the deadline 3. Now, why we're not selecting J4 and J5? J4 deadline is 2, right? With the profit 40. But we cannot select this because its deadline is 2 and deadline 2 is slot 2 is already occupied by J1. As we said, there's only one machine and it can work on only one job at a time. So J4 cannot be scheduled, though the profit is 40. Next, you have J5, profit is 20, but the deadline is again 1. The slot 1 is already occupied by J2, so it cannot be scheduled. So in fact, we cannot schedule J4 and J5. Now the next job what is remaining is J3 with the deadline 3 and profit 20. So deadline is 3, that slot was empty. If you just look at this slot is empty. So J3 is placed in this slot. Fine. Now, all the slots are occupied. You have only 3 hours, so all the job slots are occupied. And this gives you the optimal schedule, that is J2, J1, J3. So first J2 job will be process, then J1 will be carried out and then J3. Now, after doing this schedule, what will the maximum profit earn? How will you check it? That is the profit, sum of the profit of all these jobs in the optimal schedule. The first job is J2. What is the profit is 100, right? Second job is J1. Profit is 60. Third job is J3. Profit is 20. So the maximum profit earned is 180 units. It's very simple and interesting one actually, the problem, fine? Okay, the examples to try, we can try this example as well as this example, fine? So what we are doing here, we are given a set of jobs, we are given a set of deadlines and the profits associated with the job. Our main aim is to select the jobs which can be carried out within the given deadlines of the job so that we get the maximum profit. And here for selecting a job, we are applying greedy approach, right? And because we want the profit to be maximum, it's a maximization optimal profit, right? I hope the concept is clear. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.